Welcome back to another edition of Behind the Screams. I'm John Murdy, Creative Director of Halloween Horror Nights, and we've traveled across the country to be here tonight to go backstage with Alice Cooper, where he's going to share with us his brand new attraction, Alice Cooper Goes to Hell in 3D. We're here with Alice Cooper to take him through our latest maze, Alice Cooper Goes to Hell 3D. Last year we did Alice Cooper Welcome to My Nightmare, and it was a big hit.
Yeah.
It was, you know, the fans just loved it, it up, started going, God, how do we top that? How do we top that? And I thought, well, Alice Cooper Goes to Hell is the next album.
That's right.
I've always loved the name of that, and I thought, what if we took Alice Cooper and we combined it like with Dante's Inferno and the Seven Deadly Sins?
Sure. And that's basically what the idea was anyways.
The entrance of the maze is done like a Coney Island carnival spook house, and you walk through this giant head of Alice Cooper done like a snake.
Okay, let me guess this now.
Mm-hmm.
They go through the mouth of the snake, and they're in the DMV.
that is a type of hell
waiting
almost
for,
too terrifying to even portray for the public.
It'd be great. It would be hell. Would be like a giant DMV.
Purgatory is literally as if you're in a doctor's waiting room or you're at the DMV. Except all the people in the waiting room have been there forever and ever and ever, and they're all skeletons and they're covered with cobwebs.
Like the Beetlejuice.
Exactly. Thing, yeah. So as you cross the bridge over the River Styx on the way to the gates of hell, you encounter Medusa head of albino snakes and the Alice Cooper eyes, and that's a stilt walker. So that character's 8 feet tall, comes rushing out at you and drives you through the gates of hell.
So this is our guy.
We have Dr. Alice here. And Dr. Alice is
nip
doing
and tuck.
Every conceivable type of plastic surgery to this poor girl. So she's got Botox lips beyond belief. She's got, you know, the giant breast implants.
Okay.
She's had, you know, so much work done on her face that it's like spaghetti. Then you go into greed, and in this particular attraction we interpreted greed as hoarding.
Okay.
So if you've ever seen those
hoarding's big this year.
Oh, it's hoarding is very big.
Who would have thought hoarding would have been so big?
And then we arrive in wrath, and the way we interpreted this scene is we took all of the ways you've executed yourself over the years in your show and put them all in one scene. Then we have a new one as well, so here's you cut in half.
Okay.
So basically, all of the characters in the scene are versions of Alice Cooper, and all of the victims in the scene are versions of Alice Cooper.
Right,
so you're killing yourself for eternity.
I like his efficiency. He's very efficient at killing me. He is.
Well, you know, when you're drawing something like this, you have to go, I wonder what he's going to think about this. It's like, hey, so Alice, this is you cut in half.
How am I going to get that shirt washed every night? I think you're going to like it.